The Central Rebels high school football team came up just short of their seventh consecutive district title in 2018, falling to Kennett in the title game. The Rebels, led by head coach Corey Swice, are back and ready to roll in 2019, but are going to do so with a bit of a younger squad than usual. Coach Swice says that's making for a lot of competition in camp.
It's going well. You know, we've got a lot of competition right now because we're going to be young, and anytime there's competition, it makes for pretty good practices typically. So we're excited. I mean, it's not going to be a typical season for us as far as having guys ready to go week one. But our big thing is hopefully by week 9 or week 10, we're a lot better than we are at the start of the season, and better than we are right now for sure.
There are plenty of established guys on this Central Rebels team as well, though, and one of those is senior Gage Mannion, who's going to be leading the Rebels in, well, a lot of different ways this season.
Probably the biggest name coming back is Gage Mannion. He was really good for us last year in the backfield. Not a real big guy, but he's explosive and he's quick, and it's hard to tackle him early. So he'll be good, and he'll be playing on both sides of the ball, and he'll kind of be a little bit everywhere for us.
And with just 1 year left in his high school football career, Mannion has seemed to really grasp the concept of senior leadership.
You know, everyone that's pretty much a senior on this team, they get looked up to. No matter if you play, if you don't play, if you start, it don't matter. You get looked up to. And the seniors this year have been taking a big role in that, and we're really glad to have younger classmen to look up to us and make us, stand for something.
And then there's senior Dylan Corcoran, returning starting quarterback from last year, who recognizes with some key seniors from last year now gone, he'll have to pick it up in the intangibles category.
Well, yeah, for sure. I mean, a lot of them seniors last year, like Will Hopkins and Tanner Friend and Jake Casey, and we're going to miss them all. And they played such big roles on this team. Right now, we just need leaders to step up and kind of show the youngsters what's going on.
Central will couple their youth with a tough early schedule in the first two games against really quality opponents in St. Clair and MICDS. The Rebels lost to those two foes last year, but senior Blake Bowling seems to have a good idea of what their approach this season needs to be.
Yeah, we've got to prepare for a lot. One thing is we've got to prepare is that, they're gonna hit us hard on this first play, and it's just a matter of how we react to it. Are we going to back up, or are we just going to get back up and fight even harder?
Trevor Johnson is also a senior leader on this team, and he says the work they've put in the offseason will definitely carry over.
I'm very excited. I worked hard all offseason. The whole team did, and I really feel like we're all going to show up.
And Coach Swice says there's a method to the madness of playing two of the toughest opponents on the schedule in the first two games.
Well, one of the reasons we schedule the tough opponents early in the season like that is because that'll give us a good idea of personnel, like who can do what and things like that. So I think the earlier that you can get your personnel set in place, I think the better you are down the road. So we always like to test this early. That way, like I said, we can kind of see what pieces fit the puzzle, so to speak. So
the Central Rebels will indeed see their season start on Friday, August 30th against St. Clair at home in Park Hills. For Regional Radio Sports, I'm Nick Lewis.